Hello, beautiful co-creators of the new paradigm. I'm Wieteke Koolhof from Design for Awareness, and I'm here with Gabe Salomon again.
Greetings, everyone.
And we thought to make a few videos together, and this is the second one, and we're gonna talk about time management, since it's such a big topic for so many people, and especially in this time of acceleration, even though literally it's not, as I understand it, the universe is not necessarily accelerating, we're just perceiving an acceleration.
Yes.
But that doesn't take away from our experience of things going faster and faster and how to handle that. So this is a big one for many people. And we thought, let's talk about it. Gabe, so what's been your experience with this? And what would you like to say about this?
The first thing that I would like to say about this is that when you allow your resonance, meaning the expanded feeling that arises in your body when you tune into what you're excited about, when you allow your resonance to actually bring you to where you need to go, then that very mechanism is the thing that assists you in managing your time. Because when you're in the flow of your divine nature, then everything that you inevitably come across, everything that you inevitably do is for the exact amount of time that it needs to be experienced for. And then when you're listening to yourself, when you've reached a point where this activity or this thought or this emotion has been experienced to the fullest by your consciousness, then your flow naturally brings you to the next point in time.
Yes.
And so in that sense too, what I've experienced the more that I step into my own flow is that I actually begin to exist outside of time, where there seems to be, though everything is moving faster than you can even imagine, there seems to be more time for me to express what I'm truly passionate about within the span of a day.
Right, right.
What's your experience of it?
Yeah, it's the same. I can totally relate to that. But to share with other people, because I think what I had to learn, so I'll share a challenge that I had and that I'm still being invited to be aware of, because this may sound very simple, but it's a constant or almost constant thing that you have to kind of keep an eye on, because it's so easy to fall back into the old pattern of saying yes to someone here and promising something over there. And the, before you know it, your agenda seems pretty full. So it's this, it seems like a practice of self-love in a sense, to set some to set some time apart for yourself and to allow yourself to, for instance, run late for something or change a plan and just reorganize. And if that looks chaotic to your rational mind, to be okay with that, to basically surrender and go with the flow. Because yes, like you just said, you can't be behind, not really, because when you're following your highest joy, you're gonna feel like you're behind when you believe you are. So you're creating that experience. And I think that's important that we know that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that it's in our own hands, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
how we choose to spend our time is always up to us, and it's always determined by how much we truly want to listen to our hearts and move with that. And, you know, what something that we were talking about a lot before this video is that there's so many star seeds out there, so many people that know they're here for such a big purpose, who feel that they they'll never be able to catch up, that there's not enough time to create all the things that they're here to create, or that they've missed their window of opportunity. And I think especially for some of these light workers that have come in a little bit earlier than us, who are a little bit older in the physical sense, they might feel that their time has passed them by to create. And this is a very common thing for beings like us to experience, because we know that we're here to do so much, and we know that we're here to do so much in such a quote unquote seemingly small window of time, that is this transition that is occurring. So oftentimes we can feel that immense pressure. It's like if you are familiar with Atlas, the statue of Atlas, the idea of Atlas, he always has the weight of the world on his shoulders. Mm-hmm. And I feel that throughout my life, I've certainly felt that. And I know you were saying that as well. And it's something that we're learning how to balance collectively and on an individual basis.
Yes.
So the way that I have gone about doing that is every time I feel that intense pressure, that intense weight, that intense sense of there will not be enough, it's an indication for me to actually begin to relax into the idea that I'm not obligated to do anything, right, that I actually can step away from it.
Yes.
And in stepping away from it sometimes, and stepping away from your insistency of how things should manifest or what you should be doing, you end up feeding more energy back into your manifestations because you're relaxing, therefore allowing that path of least resistance to reveal itself to you, essentially.
Exactly. Yeah, that's that never-ending paradox again. That's exactly what I experience as well, when I think, oh my God, where is the time for me to paint, for instance? I'm totally creating that time right now.
Yeah.
But I used to think that, because funnily enough, even when you're already living your dream, you can still overemphasize one part of your dream.
Oh, yeah.
And now suddenly, isn't that amazing? And now you're balancing.
Oh my God.
And people could call that a luxury problem. And it's not a problem, a luxury challenge. but it's still an invitation for growth. It's still an invitation for self-examination and for getting to know yourself even better. Because I caught myself like, oh man, there's still a lack belief down here that I love to do this, so I should be doing mainly that. But then your joy starts seeping out because you're doing it, you're overdoing it. And then you realize, oh man, and you know, I can enjoy basically even doing the dishes as long as I'm just fully there with my attention. And that's a moment for recharging as well. So actually kind of organizing my house, taking a day off to do some like practical things, but to do it in an easy, flowing way, that's a recharging tool as
It's so recharging, because at a certain point, everything becomes an extension of your joy. So whether you're, as you said, you're doing the dishes, you're cleaning the house, or you're creating your next masterpiece, it's all an equal part of the whole. Mm-hmm. And I'll say, because there's so much that comes up for me when we're talking about this, when you step into a higher vibration, your life becomes big, like really big. You have opportunities at every corner that are presenting themselves to you. You have 101 different projects going on. You have all of these things manifesting in your life. I'll say for myself, I'm so busy all the time because all of these things are happening. And what occurs is it's an invitation by your higher self to step up your level of alignment and to step up your degree of balance because, you know, say more people watch my videos, then all of a sudden more of my videos are in demand by the external world. And so I'm excited because I'm seeing the external reflection. But if I go down that path and neglect my compositions, I neglect my electronic music that I love to compose, or I neglect practicing the piano, or I neglect something else in my life, then I start to feel, as you said, this one creative endeavor or expression start to stagnate.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've learned, and this is just like a very practical thing in terms of time management.
Yes.
Doing things in shorter increments.
Yes.
But allowing yourself to experience more different types of expressions. So instead of, and you know, this is once again, just from I can only speak from my life experience and from what's relevant for me. So what I've learned, because I'm creating all day, it's like, if I'm going to work on electronic music, instead of working on it for 6 hours, which I do, I have the notion, okay, you know what? I've been working on this for this long. Now, why don't I switch up the energy? Why don't I make room to go on a hike, or make room to go spend time with my friends, or to go do something else, create a video, somehow introduce a new expression within your within your reality in that moment to switch up the energy and to move into a higher degree of balance.
Yes.
Essentially.
Yes, that's what I do. I make little blocks, like you just said. And yeah. I let it flow. So I don't plan any day cramped full with stuff anymore.
Right.
There's always room in between, for instance, sessions, or in between making a painting and organizing a closet. There is room to do something spontaneously different. And I give myself permission to move things ahead in time, even though that's a concept, but I give myself permission to let some things go if they appear not to resonate with me in the moment, and just do something else.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, I'm really starting to notice the slipperiness of time, where I had some things. I had some things on the to-do list that you have to go to a special store to, for instance. And I'm not thinking about that at all, not specifically, but I know it's on the to-do list. Then I go to the market to get some fresh vegetables, and all of a sudden there's this stand that has that one product, and I don't have to go to this special store anymore. So, funnily enough, things that seem to be very time-consuming end up being delivered to me almost.
Exactly.
It's incredible.
When you're in the resonance, when you're in the flow of your excitement. And it's funny, because the more that you're in the flow of your excitement, what ends up happening is you're actually allowing more of the oneness that is all things to permeate into your reality.
Uh-huh.
And when you do that, you start to see the interconnectedness of everything that you're doing. So you start to manifest the experience of, oh, I went to the market. And also, I want to go on a hike, and there's this hiking trail that's right behind where the supermarket is. So it's like, it's, you start to just see. And once again, I think what we're speaking about is a sort of a subtle level of learning. And so this might be relevant for some people, it might not be, but you start to see that everything, when you're following your joy, is an all inclusive experience in that sense, that it is truly all connected, and that opportunities present themselves to you that are interwoven. So something, an example from my life, and I used this briefly in the last video, but nonetheless, it applies. You know, how do I give my transmissions while still incorporate music, while still incorporate imagery, while still incorporate this and that? Well, I just smash them all together into one cohesive piece of art. And therefore, I'm utilizing these different multidimensional facets to be brought within one expression. And so you find ways through your creative expression to bridge the gap between different parts of yourself.
Yes. Really. Oh, I love that you say that, because I know people who have many, many interests and many passions, and they don't know which one to pick. So I would always just tell them, you know, do whatever feels good in any given moment. And they're like, yeah, but these things are not related. And I'm like, haha, just wait.
Just wait.
Yeah, keep on doing your thing. Because somehow, if you love quantum physics and baking pies, who knows what the future will bring when you keep following.
The future.
Because everything is going, basically, I don't see limitations. I'm like, everything could happen. Just look at the last 20 years of development in technological areas and also spiritually. And once you start to realize, well, I chose to not let myself be limited also by what I see right now. I love where we are right now. I think that's really important. I also wanted to bring this in for people who are still playing with the working like part-time or full-time job.
Right.
So I tried that. Really,
so have I.
not my best experience. Freelancing was definitely, and it's been such an amazing route of learning to trust, because not knowing where your money is going to come from the next month, it's a master level of trusting life, trusting yourself. So,
oh my God, it's so beautiful. But you know what I've found is that I actually have more steady income from being a creative freelancer than I ever did when I was working a steady job. So how funny is that?
Yes, it flips. I didn't have that experience right away as a freelancer, but that's because I still wanted to learn some more. I just had to learn and transform some beliefs about money. But now I feel like this is like, wow, I'm just loving where I am. And I'm not focusing on lack anymore, because if I see it, I'm like, wow, I can still see this right now. And it's just part of what is right now, and everything that's here right now is in its divine location, in its divine way. So it can serve me, even though you might define it as a lack. So,
Oh, yeah, completely.
but I have the option to do that, so I don't. Because I'm free to
Yes.
label it as a lack, I don't. Because I don't
Yeah,
have
yeah. You don't have
to.
to. You don't have
Exactly.
to. When you see the power of your perception and your ability to choose what you subscribe to, you can totally transform your life.
Yeah.
And this is what I would say to people, because I feel this is quite relevant in this moment, for people that are wanting to branch out into being more of a freelancer
Yeah.
type individual, someone
Yes.
who's really sustaining themselves. I will say that the shift will happen fast, but allow it to take a little bit of time.
Yeah.
Allow it to be a little bit of a process, because this is something like for myself, I've been, I guess you could say, a creative freelancer for a number of years. And now it's only within this like past 6 months where it's like really taking off, where like I'm really experiencing so much abundance. So it's as you said, ultimate test in faith and in trust, but continue down that path and have absolutely no hesitation and restrictions about that. Just trust in that to the best of your ability and allow it to unfold how it will, because it doesn't unfold instantaneously all of the time in the physical sense. Mind you, when you make that shift, it is an instantaneous shift, but physical reality does have to catch up to that
Yeah,
shift.
there's an
And the reason
echo.
why it happens. There's an echo. The
Yeah.
reason why it happens is because there is a lag time built into physical reality,
Yeah.
but also it's to adjust your consciousness to feeling as if it is worthy of those things. So
Yes.
sometimes that belief takes a little bit of time to set in. So
Oh, yes.
allow that to be there and allow that to be a process and
Yes.
enjoy it. Truly enjoy it.
Do totally enjoy it. And so I could say to people that are still in a job, so this is what I did when I was still working under a boss. I would pretend that I was a freelancer, and I would bring my own my hobby to my work, in a sense. I was actually, for a while, I even worked in some kind of souvenir shop here in Amsterdam, just to make a living. But on the side, I was reading all these like self-study books, and I loved that I had time for that. So if there were no customers in the shop, I would just be doing that. And I love people, so I just made the best out of it. Whenever there was a customer, they were talking about how they loved their holiday. When you work in a souvenir shop, it's a holiday 100% of the time, because these people carry their awe for the city around them. And I got to enjoy that with them. And I was so honored to see them enjoy their trip. Or if they didn't really, I could like maybe cheer them up a little bit, you know? So there's so much beauty in the simplest job. And I worked as a cleaner a long time in my life. I paid my studies. I left the house real early. And by cleaning other people's houses, I paid for art school. And so I was really doing it the old school way. But I so always chose to trust in my dreams. And I put my heart and my passion over anything, because if I can't love where I am now, and it looks limited, maybe to the outside world, then I'm not moving away from it. So this is the first thing I would want to say to people that feel a little trapped right now. Find something, even if it's like this big, find something to love in where you are now, and you're starting to cut the chains that seem to be binding you to it. So it's just, it's all love. Love is the answer to give yourself one step at a time, and like you said, give yourself time for the process. And if you do jump into the whole freelancing experience, you're gonna draw in all kinds of new life lessons that will also ask from you again new courage for different steps. It's not ending there.
Oh man, it so doesn't end there,
No.
but in that sense it is true. Like when you put yourself in that frequency, you do stop worrying about things, or when worry does come up, you've shifted your relationship with it so much that it just kind of dissipates on its own. But it I mean, once you once you continue down this path, just speaking from experience once again, your life becomes so full, so big, so abundant with so many things that it's like, it's so hard to explain. But if you look at all the things that are happening within your own life, you could start to see that there is so much potential there, and there is already there's so much capacity for you to begin to express yourself however you want to. And I think everyone can relate to the fact that even if you just find one thing in your life, you can find evidence that you are shifting and that mm-hmm. Things are accelerating. Mm-hmm. And when you begin to put your focus into that idea that things are changing, that things are shifting, then once again, you allow more things that are representative of that frequency to come into your reality.
Yes, definitely. Mm-hmm. And I think what really helps too is to watch the way you are defining and describing your situation where you are. Because what I noticed for myself, as long as I keep saying things like, I want to go there, I'm aiming to do that, and I'm putting it away from me. I'm putting it in the far, far distance of this so-called future. Yeah. But I love saying things like, I am moving into that. I am drawing it in. It is becoming me right now. And I feel it more and more. I feel it now. And I'll feel it more tomorrow, maybe. But I'm feeling it a lot already right now.
So, yes, it's so true.
Yeah, to change your way of definitions.
Yes. And something actually, I'm doing a live stream tonight about manifestation, really. And so one of the things that I was going to mention, which feels right to bring up now, is that the reason why a lot of people get sort of caught up with not being able to bring about the things in their life that they want to is because we stop our creational momentum at the level of observing what is true around us. Meaning that we say, you know, those kind of people that are like, I'm going to tell you how it is. Life is like this. I'm like this. I don't have enough of this. And so they're observing within their reality all of the things that they feel are going on or that they're missing. And what ends up happening is that you're restricting your ability to live in future flow. And for me, future flow is the ability to constantly reorient your definition, as what you said. I'm moving into this direction. This is already happening. I can bring this in here and now, rather than it's not here, it's not here, it's not here. It's no, this is here. I'm moving into it more. I'm embodying that more. I'm allowing and enjoying the process of becoming that more. So it truly is all the way in which you choose to relate to it in every moment.
Yes. Wow. So true. Aho to that. Yes. Instead of continuing to copy paste, in a sense, what has been before, because the past, you know, doesn't have to rule the future. It just doesn't, unless you believe it has to, because it has proven to be true then.
Right.
So it has to be true in the future. No, because that's not how we went. We never moved forward by thinking that way. Like, did Einstein give up on his beautiful theory of relativity because he didn't get it right away?
Oh, of course.
Did he say like, oh, I had it wrong 100 times, I'm gonna quit right now? No, because he felt it was already there. He kept on moving towards it.
Yes.
And this is true for, I think, everybody who carries the dream of wanting to support themselves or feel the support of the universe that's actually already there for them.
Mm-hmm.
To start to redefine their vision of that.
And absolutely.
Then they can allow it in the preferred manner.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
And it's important to note that going back to something that we spoke about a little bit earlier, it doesn't seem that these things are coming in right immediately, once again, because the physical reality in of itself is always showing you the past. It's designed to show you the echo.
Yes.
So always keep in mind that your creational momentum is built by living into the future. So it's positioning your consciousness where you want to be, vibrationally speaking, and allowing physical reality to echo where you're already at, to catch up to where you're already at.
Yes, yes. I sometimes do this when I have a little challenge before me. Either with a person or a project or whatever, when I catch myself worrying or having this like unbalanced frequency about it, I'm like, oh, wait a minute, look at this, stop, breathe.
Yeah.
look at it, and when I don't instantly see a solution, I sometimes ask myself to just imagine that I'm already beyond it. And I actually imagine how I would feel if it was already solved.
Exactly.
And then I just like, oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
And, you know, from that state of being, the solution often comes.
It often comes. It always comes. And you'll see that when you can envision yourself going through the challenge with ease, oftentimes as you become more of an empowered creator, mm-hmm. it does physically manifest in a very similar way to how you were envisioning it. It's because,
well,
in my experience,
sometimes
the essence of it is the same. The essence of it, you know, it's not always how it is in the physical sense, but the essence of it is the same. And the reason why it is because when you place yourself in that proper state of being of ease, then you're actually intuitively tuning into the timeline in which you've placed yourself in to where you could see, oh, this is how it's going to feel. This is how it's going to go. And so you trust in that and you move with it.
Yeah. And you don't care what it's going to look like because that would block it again.
Right. Exactly.
Wow. I love this. Yes.
Yeah.
Wow. So, oh my God, we were again going really fast. So we're talking about time management and time is just going like crazy.
Yes.
So one thing that I still want to throw in there, because that was a private question that I had for Gabe just before we started this video, was about Facebook. So this is, apart from feeling the pressure of maybe needing to change the world, I think we kind of covered that, how you can relax in that and know that you're always divinely where you need to be in any given moment. Well, then there's still Facebook.
There's still social media.
But there's still social media. So
that's
a whole story on itself. It's a whole world on itself that has this like strong tornado power to it, like sucking you in, you know? So I asked Gabe before we started this video, how do you respond to people that share a very one-sided vision on something that isn't necessarily positive on your timeline? Do you interact, do you respond to that, or what do you do? So can you share with our viewers?
I would love to, because for the sake of being so transparent with what happens in my life, is as I reach more people with what I do, and inevitably as anyone reaches more people with their work, they're always going to have people say a lot of things about what you do. And so people come to me and they say, I'm inauthentic, I'm being this and that, I'm even an evil reptilian spreading slight, whatever it may be. I've heard a lot of it. And, you know, I'm at this point in my life, I have absolutely no desire to explain myself to anyone, because I know so fully that I'm just being who I'm being. And so what has come about in my life, the way to handle those people that have a lot of things to say, is to feel into the energy of what they're saying. And when you feel into the energy, you can read what they're saying and within 4 seconds know where they're coming from. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times when someone is coming at you or just saying a statement that's very one-sided in their vision, relax into the idea that it doesn't have to do with you. It has to do with what they're going through.
Right.
And it's the reflection that you're providing that is bringing up what they need to see within themselves. And of course, what you need to see within yourself too, which will always come up, and that's a really beautiful thing. So instead of wasting your time trying to defend your points, trying to defend yourself, when you could be using that time to send love, to send blessings, and to move in the direction of something that you're truly passionate about,
mm-hmm.
just simply either don't respond at all. Maybe if it is on Facebook, you press the love button. Maybe you just say, thank you so much for sharing your opinion, and I really appreciate you expressing your heart. And when you do that, you can begin to see so fully that everything that everyone expresses is an equal part of creation and can be loved and can be respected as such. And it only feels draining when you begin to try to defend yourself. And I'm speaking as someone that has spent so much time in their life needing to defend myself, needing to prove that I'm authentic, needing to prove that I'm this and that.
Okay.
And it's led me absolutely nowhere. The only place that it's led me is to simply know that I'm doing the best that I can. Everyone is doing the best that they can in every moment. And just to respond with just a loving comment, and that's all right. that's all that it requires. And right. and it might affect you emotionally, especially at first. You might feel emotions, but allow that to be there and just allow that to dissipate. And very quickly, the amount of negative comments become completely overshadowed by the amount of positive feedback that you get, which is really important.
Yeah. Do you also discern, like shift and sort out, by that I really literally mean, do you just click defriend sometimes?
Oh, yeah.
Goodbye? Because I'm not even going to go into this or something.
Yes. Oh, yes. Well, so I had, when I've been called an evil reptilian here to spread false light, I literally just wrote, LOL, that's very interesting. And I just defriended the person because I had, at a certain point, you just don't have any time to be saying anything about anyone or to really even be giving your energy to that. Right. And you know, here's the funny thing. It's like, everyone has so many opinions about me, but I have no opinions about anyone. I don't even really have an opinion about myself. I'm just kind of moving with my flow. And it's like, it's quite interesting to witness that. And anyway, I'm saying all this because for those of people that are watching that will inevitably begin to express themselves more. It is a byproduct of you sharing your light that people will say a lot of things about what you're doing.
Yeah.
And you just learn how to play with that, really. It's just a...
Yes, mm-hmm. I love how you put that, how to play with it. And yes, that's so beautiful. Wow. So what I did when as a little trick, because first I was actually like going into some of the comments, not necessarily not attacking my persona or something. I didn't really experience that so much.
Yeah.
But maybe just coming from a very victimhood kind of energy. And I would, respond like, you know, you can also look at it from this perspective and just offer another perspective. And then sometimes people would get angry because it would push the buttons because they really, really don't believe they can go there.
Right.
And that's okay. First that kind of put me off, I already say that. And I wasn't sure, like, should I continue this conversation or, but then, you know, it's going down spiral, you know, and I didn't feel enthusiastic anymore. So I was looking at myself like, okay, so how do I end this? And I had to learn that. But it was so beautiful for my own expansion and growth to learn how to discern. What do I really want? What do I want to talk about? So when people when people ask my opinion, I might give it if it feels like a fun dialogue.
Yeah.
If they didn't ask for it, do your thing. If it's a very negative comment, it's goodbye, you know? If you're angry with the world, okay, fine. You can do that. That's beautiful because all that is apparently also wants to be angry at some level.
Exactly. Yeah.
So you can do that and I do this. So that's my response to it now. And if it's very victimhood based, I just, I would read the story maybe, and if I first felt like triggered, I would read it again and ask myself this question: what would I have had to go through as a person to have written that?
Right.
If I was the one writing that, where did I come from? And you know, just that question would give me like insight in, oh, they were hurt, they were really hurt, they were they had pain and they're still carrying it around and they're just looking for love. They're just looking for relief. And they were trained to defend themselves and this is what they're still doing. And it's a pattern and it's okay. And I can send love and compassion to that. Or I really love this technique of Ho'oponopono. It's one of my favorite ways of responding quickly. Do you know it?
No. What? Explain.
Oh, it's a Hawaiian mantra, and it's four sentences. It's I love you, I'm sorry, forgive me, and thank you.
Oh.
So you say I love you to the higher self of the other person or of the situation, because you can you can even do Ho'oponopono for instance an oil spill. You can do it for anything that upsets you.
Yeah.
So I love you to the oversoul of it, because that part is in balance. You know, on that level there is no friction.
Right.
So I love you. I'm sorry for what we have co-created in this lower energy density.
Yeah.
And I did that too because I'm observing it. So I'm a co-creator and I'm owning it. I'm owning it.
Yeah.
Please forgive me. That's not like forgive me, I did something wrong. It's more like forgive me because I didn't know any better. I'm like a child.
It's in the empathetic sense.
Like a child is unknowing of what it sometimes creates. And this is very much where we are with humanity, I see, or at least I feel. We're still children. We're just learning how to play this game.
Yes.
So forgive me for that. There was no bad intention. And then thank you, because it's always given.
Yeah.
And I repeat the thank you part 3 times, and I really breathe in and breathe out, and then I let it go, because I healed it in myself.
Yes.
And it doesn't mean that I won't take action if I can, like, if I feel passionate about taking action for a good cause, I definitely will. But some things sometimes are very quick or feel overwhelming the first time you hear them, and then I use this mantra to deal with it.
Yes.
That's just my way. I mean,
it's such a beautiful
way. Everybody
has
their own way.
Yes. Yeah. And my way really is exactly the same. It's just going through the process of, oh, thank you for expressing yourself. I love you. And I'm happy that this co-creation occurred. Thank you so much. And it's really it. It's really, it's simple, and it's so effective.
Yeah. And it probably makes you grow, as you said.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
you know,
yeah.
With the opinions that people have about what you do, for instance.
Yeah. See, for me, those opinions, those comments, they just add fuel to my fire that I'm kindling.
Okay.
And it makes me want to be even more of myself, because I know that part of what I'm here to do, part of what the light that I bring through is doing in other people, is allowing them to observe what they need to observe within themselves, for better or for worse. So
yes,
I'm happy.
Yes, because why would you want to cancel anything out?
Yeah, no, not cancel.
it can be there, but it can also, like, you can know it can be there and still click defriend.
yes.
Just the balance.
Yeah, it's so funny. And it's a sort of a good disclaimer about this thing. You don't have to stick around and listen to people's negative comments. You can remove yourself from the situation. You can just click unfriend. You can just choose not to do it. You know, it's quite simple.
And it's up to you whether you want to explain yourself, like, in a final comment or not.
Yeah. Yeah,
because, you know, I don't know how long you knew this person already or whatever, but we all change, and with the frequency of the earth moving so rapidly right now, and people will navigate to those that are on the same frequency and kind of like pushing two magnets towards each other in the wrong way, you know.
And
you won't be able to get them to connect. That's what you will start to notice with people who are on really no longer your wavelength. And I think it's important for all of us who are following our hearts and our passions and our joy, that if we want to do any time management, start there. Because it's so time consuming to keep hanging around the people that no longer nourish your beautiful, inspirational path.
Yes, it's really true. And it has, for me, it's come with the understanding that everyone that comes into your life is ultimately a gift, and that ultimately they will come and go, and ultimately a new group of people will come in, and ultimately, you know, life is in a continuum of flux. You're always having new experiences, and everyone that is brought into your journey is just here to provide you a different archetypal reflection of yourself. So when you can come at it with this understanding of how the mechanism of this all works, then you can flow freely with whoever comes into your life and whoever chooses to leave. And it's not without, of course, being compassionate, but you do have to really use discernment and saying, is this friendship really providing me with the growth and the expansion that I need? And you'll start to see that when you begin to gravitate towards those that are like, this person's going to be in my life forever, then everyone else that isn't of that same nourishment, you know, you don't have to necessarily push them away, but you can have a better understanding and a better way of gauging who's really relevant for you to interact with. You know?
Yeah. For me, it also makes people, the ones that used to push my boundaries in the past so far, I could really start to see them as teachers at some point, because I had a hard time longer back in time as we create past from
Yes.
the now in
Yes.
that timeline.
Yes.
I was creating a difficulty for myself letting go because I was suffering from guilt, and I just made this concept in my mind that I couldn't say no in a sense because that would be
Right.
impolite.
Yes.
But that was it was impolite. It was impolite to my own higher self. It was impolite to my dreams. So, and I'm so grateful for all these people that pushed my boundaries in that sense because they helped me grow stronger. And that is such a beautiful gift. And without them, I wouldn't have learned half about what I know now about time management. So
Yes.
thank you.
So yes. Yes, thank you to all the people that have brought the challenges
Yes. Oh, this is
into our
such a
lives.
beautiful way to round it off, I
Yeah,
think.
I think so. I
Yay.
think it's great.
Wow, Gabe, thank you for your time. And everybody else for watching. I hope you really enjoyed it and maybe it gave you some inspiration.
Yes.
And maybe we will see you another time. But we love you so much and keep
Love
on
you, love.
shining, follow your heart, and yeah, thank you for who you are.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. I love all of you. Have a wonderful
Yay.
rest of the day.
Yes. Ciao.
Ciao.